Hi, I'm Tracy Shields, a biomedical librarian at the NIH Library. In this section of searching the literature, we're going to look specifically at PubMed and talk a little bit how to best search PubMed. We're also going to explore some limits and filters, along with talking about your search history for some other features and tools that you may be less familiar with. And we're also going to talk about how to set up literature alerts and get a citation from your results. So as I mentioned in a previous section, PubMed is produced by the U.S. National Library of Medicine, or NLM, and it actually includes a database called Medline, along with other things, including a repository called PubMed Central, which does have full text access. It is free to search, but it also may be available, as I mentioned, Medline, in other platforms, but PubMed itself is free to search as long as you have access to the internet. It does not allow you to search full text, but there is some full text available through PubMed Central, so you may have access to full text, even though you're not actually searching the full text. So as we talked about in previous sections, we have a question using our PICOS framework that we developed a search strategy too. We're going to use this search strategy in PubMed to see results and then be able to apply filters to best get the information we need for a comprehensive literature search. So taking this search strategy, you can go to PubMed and you can actually copy or type out the entire search strategy, but I recommend copy-paste because you're going to be typing a lot probably otherwise. But you can copy and paste your search strategy into the main search box and then click search. There's also an advanced option, which we'll go over in a little bit, that is linked to under the search box if you need a little more space or want to have a little more control from the very beginning. But when you click to search PubMed, what you will get is this list of results in PubMed. And there's a few things I want to point out on this page. At the top right, you'll see something called the display settings, and that's where you can change your display. We'll talk more about that in a minute. On the left side, you will see a list of limits. You'll see usually a graph showing how much has been published per year on your topic. And then there's also, again, a link to the advanced search page if you want to see more. Let's go into a little bit about the display options. In PubMed, the default setting is to be something called a best match sort and showing only 10 results on a page. If you are looking at a lot of results, that can mean a lot of clicking, and best match may not necessarily be exactly what you want. So one of my suggestions is to change your display options to summary format, showing the most recent, and showing more than 10 on a page. You may want to test out what number you want on a page. My sweet spot is 50 results because that allows me to see a lot of things at once and not have to click through a lot of pages. You also have an option to show or hide snippets as you scroll through your results. On the results page, you will also be able to scroll down and see other search limits and other filters that are available to you. When you click to show additional filters, a little box will pop up to show what is available as a filter, and you can then select things that you want to show up on that left side of the page. And then you will need to select those things on the left side to then be applied to your search strategy and results. When you have filters applied, you'll see a little notice at the top of your screen of results showing what filters have been applied, and you'll also see that the number of results that you've retrieved has decreased to restrict to those filters. I mentioned the advanced search page before, so let's talk a little bit about that. Again, it's linked to under the search box on the main page or at the top of the search box on the results page. The advanced page is very handy because that is where you'll see the search history and details about your search. So let's take a few moments to talk about that. One of the nice things is if you do multiple searches in PubMed, you can see all of your searches in one place, including if you turn on and off filters or other limits, and you can see the number of results on your history page to see what searches you have done. There's also an option to click to see details, and that tells you what searching has been done on your behalf, kind of behind the scenes. PubMed might be doing a lot of things in addition to even the search terms that you came up with. So this is good to know because if you start looking through results and you see a lot of unexpected things, it could be because of the search terms that you've done have other things going on behind the scenes in the background. In this case, you'll see the translation that PubMed did with our search for our strategy that includes other terms, synonyms, and something called mesh terms or medical subject headings. There's also actions that you can change that will give you other options for your search, whether it's adding to the query, deleting it, or something called creating an alert, which we'll talk about more in a bit. On the results page, you can click on the title of a result, and it will take you to something called the abstract view, which is one page showing all the information about that particular record. It'll often show the abstract if it's available, but it'll also show things like links to full text, along with details about the record that you may not see on the results page. With links to full text, keep in mind that some of these may be fee-based, but if you look for something called PMC, free full text, that is something that is available through PubMed Central and is directly linked in PubMed. For other things that aren't free, I suggest you check with your library to see what content might be available to you. Something else to notice if you scroll down on that abstract view page for a particular citation is that you'll come across something called similar articles. And these are things that could be linked to by who has cited them, the terms that you've done, and it's a good way to discover more literature in PubMed apart from your search itself. In many cases, you'll see overlap with the search results that you've done with your initial search, but you may also discover things that you would not have found otherwise. And usually it lists 3 or 4, at most 5, results of similar articles for this particular citation, but you can also see a link to see all similar articles, and it'll open up a new page with a list of all new results. On this abstract view page is a little button that may kind of get lost called Cite, and this is a really handy part of PubMed because finding a citation and formatting a citation is often a very unpleasant process to a lot of people. PubMed makes it easy to get a citation by clicking on that and popping up a box with the citation information. It also gives you options of changing the format to AMA, APA, or even MLA, with the default being NLM's format itself. You can then copy this into a Word document or whatever you're working on, or you can even do something where you send this to a citation manager, which we'll talk more about in a later session. So I had mentioned before that you can set up alerts and save things. You'll notice, again, by going back to the results page, there is a little section of save, email, or send to that's available under the search box. Saving your search is something that requires a MyNCBI account, which we'll talk more about in a moment. But you can also just email results to yourself or others, and you can make a determination if you want to email everything or the selected ones that you want. And by selecting things, you can click on those little check boxes next to each citation to select the ones that you want to save, email, or send. Send to gives you an option to send it to a temporary thing called a clipboard, or you can do more with a MyNCBI account. On the advanced page, you will also have an option to create alerts, just like you do at the top of a results page. This again requires a MyNCBI account, and it allows you to set up an alert through MyNCBI to send you results or to do other things. So with a MyNCBI account, what this allows you to do is set up personalizations in PubMed, such as saving alerts or saving searches, or even having certain display settings of your choice. To log into a MyNCBI account now requires a third-party sign-up or login. And you can pick which one fits best for you. It could be a Google account. It could be a specific account linked to your ORCID if you're a researcher. And you keep in mind that you may need to authenticate through another app in order to log into PubMed this way. But once you're logged in, it'll show up at the top right of your screen, and it will give you options to save and do more things. So some tips and advice about PubMed. Searching is iterative, and it could be multiple searches to get what you need. And that advanced search page with its search history will be an invaluable way to kind of go back and forth between these iterative searches and to kind of keep track of what you're doing. You can also review your search results for additional terms and ideas and things that you want to search. And you can use that advanced search page too to help document your process. There's an option on the search history to download your search history into essentially an Excel spreadsheet. And then there's always the PubMed FAQs and user guide that has a lot more details than can be covered here on how to search some of the search fields and advanced things that you can do in PubMed to be effective in your searching. So in summary, PubMed has a lot of powerful features that can assist you with your search. If you look at your search history details, you can see what might be happening to your search behind the scenes even more than what you initially planned to do. You can change your display settings, apply limits and filters to make your search go easier. And that cite button to get a citation is a really handy way to do some unpleasant things that you may want to try to avoid. Have your tools work for you. And you can use a MyNCBI account to save your searches, set up alerts, and do more. So some questions to consider is, what features of PubMed can help you focus your search? And how can you see what is happening behind the scenes of your PubMed searches? Thank you for listening.